of our feet together. Knees out wide, starting to move down on our backs. Today is Wednesday, so we'll be doing flow with power options. And again, before we start, I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong. Starting to connect with the breath, breathing into a four count, holding to a four count, and exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction from the tops of your throats down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your hearts, to track the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. And exhale, 2, 3, 4. Again, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. One more time, inhale. 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore, and allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual, and it could be for you or for someone you love. We're going to send all of the healing. and love possible to Alice today, hoping that she heals quickly. Again, sending white light to her, as much good energy as possible. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. And one deep exhale. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over that right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist, opening up those right obliques as you do. And smile again. It's Wednesday. It's a beautiful day out today. Nice and cloudy, not too hot. Inhale back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist, opening up those left obliques as we do. Releasing toxins. Inhale back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys as you do. Good job. And then from here, extend your legs upward. Flex your feet. Draw your arms up overhead. We'll do happy baby after. Allow your legs to come down to a 45-degree angle. Inhale first. Exhale as you crunch it out. Inhale out. Exhale, crunch it out. Inhale out. Exhale, crunch it out. Two more or seven more, wherever you are. Inhale out. Exhale, crunch it out. Inhale out. Exhale, crunch it out. And again, you can stop here or follow us. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale in. One more. Inhale out and exhale in. Good job. Draw your knees in for a hug. Rock back and forth. And then grab your insteps. Drag your knees in towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet. Pull down with your hands in happy baby. Rocking back and forth. Massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. And smile again. It's Wednesday. It's a beautiful day out today. Sending so much love and positive energy to Alice. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend your legs down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your left side. Left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale, that right knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, drag that right shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out in infinity pose. And smile again. It's Wednesday. Thank you. Maybe grab onto your calf muscle, drag your leg towards you if this is in your practice, in a deeper stretch. Again, in infinity pose. Draw that right knee in. Exhale down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your right side, right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale that left knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, drag that left shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out. In infinity pose. Maybe grab onto your calf muscle, drag it towards you if this is in your practice. Inhale, that left knee in. Exhale, extend below you. And then place your hands behind your thighs. Spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again. Allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment. We'll do three or four of these. And arrive at the tops of your mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose, crisscross applesauce. Good job. Let's go ahead, inhale through your noses as you draw those shoulders all the way up to your ears, and then exhale as you drag them back and down, opening those hearts as much as possible. Inhale your arms all the way up, inhaling gratitude. And then exhale as you release whatever does not serve you. Inhale all the way up. Exhale again, release whatever does not serve you. One more time, inhale all the way up as we inhale healing for Alice and everyone around us. Exhale as we release any pain, any discomfort. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and inhale first. Exhale as we extend that right leg. Flex your foot. We're moving into gatekeeper. Inhale that left arm up and over as you slide that right arm down. Again, finding those right toes with your left hand in gatekeeper. Opening up those left obliques as much as possible. And smile again. It's Wednesday. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, reach, 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 as far as you can. Fingertips come down, hearts come down, third eye comes down. In humbly bowing, gatekeeper, maybe rock that third eye back and forth, opening up your intuition. But keeping your knee and your toes facing the ceiling. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk them to the left. Grabbing onto your left knee with your right hand. Bring that left hand back. Again, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale, that left arm up and over. Find your right toes once again. In twisted Janyasana. Inhale, that right shoulder through. Exhale, down, chin to shin. In traditional Janyasana. Maybe place that left hand over your left kidney, forcing the breath into your kidney, keeping it healthy as you do, puffing it out. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you bend your right knee. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend that left leg. Again, moving into gatekeeper, draw that right heel in. Inhale that right arm up and over. Find those left toes. Again, in gatekeeper. Opening up those right obliques as we do, and smile. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale both arms. All the way up. Exhale as you fold forward into the hips. Reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down, hearts come down. In humbly bowing, gatekeeper. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk your hands to the right, grabbing onto your right knee with your left hand. Bring that right hand back, shoulders back and down. Again, opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Inhale, that right arm up and over. Find those left toes in twisted Janyushirshasana. Opening up that whole right side of your body. Inhale, that left shoulder through. Exhale down. Again, into traditional Janyushirshasana. Maybe place that right hand over your right kidney. Puffing the breath into that kidney, keeping it healthy as you do. Inhale as you walk your hands back again. Exhale as you bend your knee. Place your hands on the mat in front of you. Roll up into table. In table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees, and if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Let's go ahead and first inhale, cow, drag your spines down, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, bending your elbows as you transition, dragging your spines up towards the ceiling, gazing at your navels. Inhale to cow. Forgot to say that was cat, but that's okay, I know you know it's cat. Exhale to cat, gazing at your navels. One last time, inhale to cow, and exhale to cat. Good job. Come back to a flat back. We're moving into sunbird. Inhale, that right arm straight out, left leg goes back, flex your foot. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale out, thumb is up, foot is flexed. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale out. Wrap that right arm around, bend your knee, grab onto your foot, and then pull up into modified dancer, modified bow pose, heart opener. Exhale down. Inhale, I'm gonna tuck my shirt in, it's bothering me. Inhale that left arm straight out, right leg goes back. Good job, we're in sunbird once again. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Wrap that left arm around. Bend your knee. Grab onto your foot or your ankle. Pull up into modified dancer, modified bow pose. Good job. Exhale, down. Curl your toes under, sit back on your heels. Excuse me. Drag those shoulders back and down as well. Make infinity symbols with your wrists. Opening up your wrists. Opening up your toes and your ankles as you do. Maybe draw those arms overhead. Again, in the Uttita, drag your tailbone in as you do. Possibly draw your fingertips behind you, pushing your fingertips up towards the crowns of your heads. Again, in Anjali Mudra. Good. I just love being on my toes right now. This is something that is just so helpful after wearing high heels. So just remember this. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Walk forward on your elbows. Slap out those. And then from here, plant the palms of your hands into the mat, as well as your toes. Inhale first, exhale all the way back to Ardha Mukha Shavasana, downward facing dog. Again, flattening out your backs, dragging your hearts towards your thighs. Breathing in and out. Good job. Again, maybe walking your dog, lifting first one heel and then the other, dragging the other one down towards the mat. Tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat, drag your tailbone in, step or jump up, lighter than air, inhale, halfway up, to Ardha Tadasana. Sorry, I just was thinking about the last time that I heard Morgan singing this at his godfather's house again, by the pool. In France, right before he was leaving for China. And unfortunately, I'm not really a fan of Nelly, but this song is just so beautiful. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Slightly bend your knees, inhale all the way up, swan dive backward, hands come together, slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra, bowing our heads in honor of our practices. And again,
apologize. It's funny, I get to hear this all the time, but just after this conference, it has so much meaning to me. By the way, it was an awesome conference. I know that I've already said that, but it really was an awesome, awesome conference. We're going to be moving into reverse triangle. So grow all four corners of your feet into the earth first. Lift your toes. Again, we're into the asana, mountain pose. Find that drishti. Calf muscles moving in. Thighs moving in, pelvis down the back, abdomen is in, our shoulders are back and down, and the crowns of our heads are moving towards the heavens. Our hands are open to receive in Tadasana. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that right tippy toe. Draw your right heel to your left ankle, to your left calf, or to your left thigh. Again, we're in Vrikshasana A, B, or C. Inhale, those arms up overhead into Talasana or palm tree. Mudita. And down. Draw your knee to a marching position. Flex your foot. Inhale those arms all the way up into stork. Mudita. And down. Take a giant step back with that right foot. Maybe walk that left foot forward. Draw your hands to Venus Mudra. Square your hips to the front of the room, shoulders back and down. Inhale first. Exhale as you humbly bow yourself over that left thigh as far as you can, maybe allowing your wrist to fall towards the center of the room with gravity. Draw your wrist back towards your waist before you release, placing them on either side of your foot. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha, flat back. Exhale down, grab onto your ankle, pull yourselves in if you can. Again, we're in pyramid. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha. Place that right hand on the left side of your foot. Open up to the side wall again. Shoulders back and down in reverse triangle. Is there something else you're searching for? Exhale down. Inhale halfway up. Place that left hand on the inside of your left foot. Open up to the side wall through the breath. Again, squaring your hips to the side wall, as well as your shoulders to the side wall in Trikonasana. So this is traditional Trikonasana. Should look like a straight line if you can. Exhale down. Inhale halfway up. Exhale down as you pull yourselves in one more time, as close as you can, chin to shin. Inhale all the way up. Swan dive backward. Exhale those hands down to Anjali Mudra. Bend your left knee. Inhale as you march forward into a marching position. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down. Good job. Shake it out. Sorry, I don't usually get this emotional. I don't know what's happening. Very, very exciting to think that we were able to get through that conference with the help of Jeff and Lynn and so many others. But we're starting to work on the next one, the fourth one. Work never stops. All four corners of our feet are growing into the mat. Lift your toes. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that left tippy toe. Draw your left heel to your right ankle, right calf, or right thigh. Wherever you are is perfect. Vrikshasana A, B, or C. Inhale those arms up overhead into Talasana or palm tree. Uttita. And down. Draw your knee to a marching position. Flex your foot. Inhale your arms up overhead into stork. Uttita. And down. Take a giant step back with your left foot. We're moving into pyramid. So square those hips to the front of the wall. Of the room. Draw your hands to Venus Mudra. Shoulders back and down. Inhale first, maybe walk that right foot forward. Exhale over that right thigh as far as you can. Again, and then just melt. Good job. Draw your hands back to your waist. And then release. Inhale up again to Anjali Mudra. Exhale down, grab onto your ankle, pull yourselves in as much as you can. Inhale halfway up. Place that left hand on the outside of your right foot. Open up to the side wall through the breath. Squaring your hips to the front, shoulders to the side. Reverse Trikonasana. Exhale down. Inhale halfway up. Exhale as you pull yourselves in one more time. Pyramid, inhale halfway up. Place that right hand on the inside of your right foot. Open up to the side wall. And again, square those hips to the side wall. Lift it back, right hip forward. Shoulders square to the side wall as well. In traditional Trikonasana. Exhale down. Inhale halfway up. Exhale as you pull yourselves in as much as you can. Inhale all the way up, swan dive backward, hands come together. Exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Bend that front knee. Inhale as you step forward into a marching position. Flex that left foot. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down. Good job. Shake it out. Come up to the tops of your mats. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale halfway up. Take a giant step back with your left foot. Walk your right foot all the way across. Right foot down, or right knee down, left knee down, left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Take Venus Mudra.
exhale as you humbly bow yourselves. Coming down onto that left cheek. Again, breathing in and out. Before you release, and again, we're allowing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing on that right hip to melt into the mat, into the floor, into the earth below, where it is recycled, regenerated, reborn as healing energy. Slowly inhale as we walk those hands back again. Coming off on your right hip, swing your left leg all the way around. Left leg is parallel, left foot is parallel to your right foot. Wait, left foot is parallel to your right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find that right hip crease. Maybe take a bind again in the Mariandrasana twist. Breathing in and out. Opening up your hearts to the side wall. Massaging your internal organs, releasing toxins as you go. Haven't had a lot of toxins in a really long time since Cyril can't drink wine. And we never usually drink very much wine anyway, but now Alix and Michael are here. So Alix can't drink any wine, but Michael can. So it's kind of fun to have a glass of wine with him. So I'm releasing that glass of wine from last night. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs, shake them out. Come up to the tops of your mats in Malasana Yogi Squat. And today, since it's Wednesday, let's go ahead and move into Bakasana if this is in your practice. Now, in Bakasana, we're going to stay here for 20 seconds if that's okay. So, rocking back and forth, finding that sweet spot. And then rocking into Bakasana, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then we're in Malasana. Inhale from your root chakra all the way up to your crown chakra and exhale down again. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Inhale. Good job. Let's go ahead and place our hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up the Ardha. Take a giant step back this time with your right foot. Walk that left foot all the way across. Left knee down, right knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Take Venus Mudra and exhale as you humbly bow yourselves.
Again, coming down onto that right cheek maybe, or on your elbows, or on your left cheek. Alix and Michael got to go hiking this morning because it was so beautiful. Michael was very kind about asking if I'd like to come as well, and I did want to come, but I had too much to do. And so he said to me, so basically, all that you're doing lately is yoga. And I said, yes. And he said, that doesn't seem like enough exercise. But I must say that I still feel fabulous, even if I don't get my hiking in when it's too hot in the afternoon. I think that yoga actually covers all the basic things that we need. And it certainly allowed me to run from one end to the other of the hotel for 4 days. No, 5 days this weekend. I hope you all feel the same way, but you probably have more time to be able to go hiking in the morning or in the afternoon. It's just been so hot though. I can't wait to be able to do it in the afternoon. Draw those wrists back towards your waist and then release. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Coming off on that left hip. Right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring your left foot in and your left elbow in. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find your left hip crease. Again, possibly take a bind, dragging those shoulders back and down in the Mariandrasana twist. Opening your hearts to the side wall through the breath. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Bend your knees. Arms come out on either side of your knees. Inhale first. Exhale inch by inch. Vertebra by vertebra coming down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. Place your heels just below your sit bones. Inhale as you push your hips up, placing your block underneath your sacrum. Again, on the highest, second or third levels. Maybe draw those arms overhead. Possibly walk your feet out. Again, in a T formation or a mushroom formation. I'd like to see someone who could actually make a T formation. Meaning that you'd have to, I mean, I guess you could do it with your legs, but you also have to pull, so you'd just be balancing on your sacrum. I think that would be pretty impossible. So let's just call it a mushroom formation. Draw those arms back overhead, walk your feet in, inhale as you push your hips. Release the block and exhale down. We're going to go ahead and move into a shoulder stand. Either leg straight up, flexing your feet if this is in your practice, or pushing your hips up, walking your shoulders under in a shoulder stand. Again, looking like a candlestick, feet are in Barbie feet. Perfect Barbie outfit today, too. Barbie in space. Draw those toes overhead into halasana or plow pose, but be gentle with yourselves. Make sure that whatever you do is not painful. Maybe place your knees over your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, coming back down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug. Inhale through your noses, side out, inhale. Good job. One more time, inhale.
cross that right foot over left, wrap your feet, right arm under left, wrap your arms, eagle legs. Inhale as you push your fingers and toes down to the mat. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back, and this time, exhale as you come forward, allowing those knees to fall to the left and arms to the right. So this is an eagle twist and it's very intense. You might want to have those arms out east and west, getting rid of any toxins that may remain. Inhale back to center, unwrap, unwind. Cross that left leg over right. Left arm under right. Again, let's do this one more time. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Exhale as you draw them in. One more time. Inhale back. Exhale, draw them in. And the knees fall to the right, arms fall to the left in an eagle twist. And again, this is a very intense twist. You can have those arms out east and west if you'd like. Inhale back to center, unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. Inhale through your noses, sigh it out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso. Palms are up to receive, down to ground, starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos. Relax your fingers. Relax your forearms, relax your elbows, relax your upper arms. Relax your shoulders, relax your necks, relax your jaws. Relax your cheeks, relax your foreheads, relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. To bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead, extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed, hands are in Anjali Mudra, heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Wednesday. Have a wonderful rest of the day. Again, sending so much love to Alice. Namaste. I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong to end practice. Thank you for being here. I'm so glad that you were able to join me today. I'm going to stop the recording.